हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। दिस इज हिमांशु वर्मा। टिल नाउ वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट पैरेलल प्लेन वेवगाइड। इन पैरेलल प्लेन वेवगाइड देयर वाज रिस्ट्रिक्शन ओनली इन वन साइड, दैट वाज अलोंग द एक्स एक्सिस। बट दिस टाइप ऑफ वेवगाइड कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट प्रैक्टिकली, बिकॉज प्रैक्टिकली वी कैन नॉट प्लेस टू वेवगाइड्स पैरेलल टू ईच अदर विदाउट एनी सपोर्ट बिटवीन देम। That's why for practical purpose we generally use rectangular waveguide. In rectangular waveguide we bring restriction in y direction also. That is, now it look likes a hollow rectangular pipe. In this rectangular pipe the electromagnetic wave will propagate in z direction after striking the walls in x direction as well as in y direction. In the parallel plane waveguide the electromagnetic wave was striking with top and bottom planes. But now in rectangular waveguide, the wave will strikes with top bottom as well as left and right plane also. And after multiple reflections, the wave will propagate in certain direction, that is z-axis. In rectangular waveguide, generally separation between the planes in x direction is bigger than the separation between the planes in y direction. The x direction separation is denoted by small a and y direction separation is denoted by small b. Now to study rectangular waveguide, we would try to use analogy with parallel plane waveguide. It means we have studied parallel plane waveguides in detail, but now to study rectangular waveguide, we will just use analogy with parallel plane waveguide. In rectangular waveguide also, mainly two modes of propagation exist. One is transverse magnetic and second one is transverse electric. In transverse magnetic, the magnetic field component will always remain perpendicular to z-axis, and that's why magnetic field does not have any component in z-direction, because magnetic field is transverse or perpendicular to z-axis and therefore hz is equal to 0. But in transverse electric mode of propagation, electric field is always perpendicular to z-axis and therefore electric field does not have any component in z-direction, and that's why ez is always equal to 0 in TE mode of propagation. Now if we talk about other field components, then in rectangular waveguide the wave will incident on all planes, that is top, bottom and left, right, with a certain angle. Due to incidence of wave on all planes at some angle, now all possible field components can exist. All possible field components are EX EY, HX HY and EZ HZ. Now these EZ and HZ components are very important, because only these two components decide whether the wave propagation is TM or TE. In TM mode of propagation, EZ will exist and HZ will be equal to 0. But in TE mode of propagation, HZ will exist and EZ will be equal to 0. Finally, we can say that in transverse magnetic, EZ will exist along with EX, EY, HX, HY. And in TE mode of wave propagation, HZ will exist along with EX, EY, HX, HY. So these are five field components which exist in both propagation. Now next question is, how to write the expressions for all these field components? First we write field components for TM. In waveguide propagation, Z direction is very important. So first of all, we write field expression for EZ. EZ is equal to, first of all, amplitude term, that would be constant, suppose it is C1. Now in rectangular waveguide, there is restriction on wave in x direction, that's why there would be a standing wave in x direction. In rectangular waveguide, there is a restriction in y direction also, that's why there would be a standing wave in y direction also. If we take analogy with parallel plane waveguide, then we can say, in x direction, the controlling phase constant is denoted by hx, and in y direction, the controlling phase constant can be denoted by hy. Now next question arises, these standing wave functions would be sine or cosine. That can be decided by using proper boundary conditions. Suppose this is a rectangular waveguide, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. The separation between the planes in x direction is a, and in y direction is b. If this is x and this is y direction, then z direction would be into the paper. As I want to write ez components, I show this component by cross and mark it ez. Now this EZ component can strike with all these four walls. And because this component is in Z direction, that's why for all four walls, this component would always remain tangential to the walls. Because this is an electric field component and it is tangential in this direction as well as in this direction. So it has to become zero on the boundaries. And this condition can be satisfied only if both of these functions are of sine function. So for x direction, I write sine of phase constant in x direction, that is hx into x. For y direction also, I write sine of phase constant in y direction, that is hy into y. Now after writing standing waves, now I write traveling wave component. And traveling is in z direction, and in z direction, controlling phase constant is denoted by beta bar. So I write e power minus j beta bar z. And because this field has z direction, so I write a z cap. Similarly, we can write ex. We draw same waveguide again. And now I mark ex field, that is in x direction, denoted by ex. And I found that this field component is tangential to both of these boundary walls, but this field component is perpendicular to these two boundary walls. Or in other words, we can say that it is tangential in y direction and normal in x direction. So in y direction, sine function will come, and for x direction, cosine function will come. This is written over here. Then similarly, e power minus j beta bar z ax cap. Now we write ey. So ey can be represented by this. It is tangential in this direction, that is in x direction, and normal in y direction. So in y direction, cosine will come, and in x direction, sine will come. Now for hx, because in case of magnetic field, normal component has to become zero on the boundaries. Therefore, similarly we write hx, but now hx is normal in x direction and tangential in y direction. Because hx is normal in x direction, so x direction would be of sine function and y direction would be of cosine function. If we write hy, then for hy, it is normal in y direction and tangential in x direction. So in y direction sine will come and in x direction cosine will come. So in this way, we can write expressions for all field components for TM mode. Now if we write field expressions for TE mode, where hz, ex, ey, hx, hy are exist, first of all we write hz component. Similarly, we draw the coordinate axis and mark the hz. Because z direction is into the paper, so it can be marked with cross. Now we observe that this hz component is tangential to all walls. That is, it is tangential in x direction boundary as well as in y direction boundary. Because it is tangential component of magnetic field, it need not to become zero on the boundaries. Therefore, both components, that is in x direction and in y direction, will be of cosine function. Now next we write ex. Because x is in this direction, so ex can be marked like this. This ex field is tangential in y direction and normal in x direction. Because it is tangential in y direction, so it has to become zero on the boundaries. So y direction function would be sine and x direction function would be cosine. Next we write ey. Ey is tangential in x direction and normal in y direction. So in x direction it would be sine and in y direction it would be cosine. Similarly for hx, because now it is magnetic field component, so it would be zero on the boundaries for perpendicular component. Because hx is perpendicular in x direction, that's why in x direction sine function will come and in y direction cosine function will come. For hy, in y direction it is normal, so in y direction sine function will come and in x direction cosine function will come. So in this way, we can write all field components for TE as well as TM mode of propagation. Friends, we stop here. In the next lecture, we will discuss what are these hx, hy and beta bar. Please like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.